continuation of the chapter 6 of class 11. In our previous class, we have seen many terms related to sets, such as types of sets, subsets and power set. And today we are going to learn the concept intervals as subsets of real numbers. So before going into the topic, first we will see what is real numbers. So real number, you know, real numbers usually we will denote by the letter R, and real number collection is a collection of rational numbers and irrational numbers. So real number is a collection of rational numbers and irrational numbers. And this rational number we will denote by the letter Q, and the irrational number we will denote by the letter T. So you know that what is rational number? A number which we can express in the form P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0, are called rational numbers. So we will denote that as set of all x such that x is equal to P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. So this type of numbers we will call as rational numbers. Now irrational numbers. So how we will write irrational numbers? Set of all x such that x is a real number but x is not a rational number. So this is how we will represent irrational number. Now again, if you see this rational numbers, here we have the set of integers. You know that rational numbers, we will have set of integers also. So we can write minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. So this collection also in rational numbers only. And we will denote this as integers as z or I. So integers we can denote by z or I. Again, if you see this integers from 0 to 1 to 3, we can call it as whole number, collection of whole numbers. So we can call it as whole numbers, and we will denote by the letter W. Again, if you see from 1 to 3, if you see from 1 to 3, we can say that it is natural numbers, counting numbers or natural numbers, and we will denote by the letter N. So if you see real number, this here we can see many subsets of real numbers. So we will write now, first if you take natural number, set of natural number, then the natural number is contained in whole numbers. That is, natural number is a subset of set of whole numbers. So we can write N is a subset of W. Again, if you see, this whole number is contained in integers. So we can say that this whole number collection is a subset of integers. So we can write this W is a subset of Z. Again, if you see this Z, that integers is contained in set of rational numbers. So we can write it is a subset of Q. And finally, this rational number is a subset of real number. So we will get this relationship. Okay, so the real number, we have many subsets of real number N, W, Z, Q. And what about then irrational number collection? Yes, irrational number collection is also a subset of real numbers only. So these are the subsets of real numbers. Now we will go to another one, that is what do you mean by intervals? So we will see in detail now. So let us consider a number line. So let us consider a number line. Sorry, plus infinity, minus infinity, 0. Let us consider a number line. So we have 0 here, 1, 2, 3. So if I am taking a part of the number line, that is a portion of the number line. For example, if I am taking only this portion, that is from 0 to 2. So, is it a subset of real numbers? Yes, this is also a subset of real numbers because this is a part of number line. So, if you take any portion, any part of a number line, that is also a subset of real numbers because you know that all the numbers on the number line are real numbers. And you know that numbers between 0 and 2, how many numbers you can find? There are infinite number of real numbers are there between 0 and 2. So this portion is also a subset of real numbers. Now this is called actually intervals. So intervals are actually a portion of the number line, which is also a subset of real numbers. Now, when I am saying this portion, you will have a doubt whether this endpoints 0 and 2 is included or whether it is excluded. So, based on the inclusion or the exclusion of the endpoints, there are four types of intervals. So, we have four types of intervals. So, first case, so first one, I am not considering, I am not including these endpoints, that is 0 and 2 are the endpoints. So, I am not including the endpoints 0 and 2. Then, how will you represent this? So, this is nothing but x is a real number and x belongs to, x is between 0 and 2. X is a real number and x lies between 0 and 2. This is the first case. Here I have not included the endpoint 0 and 2. Now we will consider. So this is the first case. Now we will consider the second case where I will include this endpoint 0 and 2. So I can write like x belongs to R and I am including means 0 is included, so we will have this equal sign also. So 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2. This is the second type. Now third type, what is the third type? I am going to include only one endpoint. It can be either 0 or 2. So let x belongs to R and 0 is included. So, the endpoint 0 is included but 2 is not included. So, this is the third type. Now, fourth one, let of all x belongs to R, 0, endpoint 0 is not included but 2 is included. So, these are the four types of intervals we are going to discuss now. Now, we will see one by one. So, in the first case, 0 less than x less than 2, here the endpoints 0 and 2 are not included. We will call this type of intervals as open interval. So, here if the endpoints are not included, we will call the interval as open interval, and we will denote by normal bracket. We use this bracket to denote open interval. So open interval 0 to we can denote like this. So this is the first type interval, open interval. Next one, in the second case, here we have the endpoints 0 and 2 are included. So, in this case, we will call this as closed interval. Closed interval. Here, we will use the square bracket to denote closed interval. We will use this bracket and we will write the endpoints like this. So, its meaning, we can read this as closed interval 0 to. Now, we will move on to the third one. Here, one endpoint is included. That means one side is closed and the other side is open. So, we can call it as closed open interval. So, which side the endpoint is included, there we will use square bracket, that is 0. Here, 2 is not included. So, this kind of normal bracket we will use. This we will read as closed open 0 to. Now we will go to the fourth case. Here the endpoint 0 is not included but 2 is included. So we will call this as open closed. That is open closed 0 to. So these are the four types of intervals. Now how can we represent these intervals in set builder form and how can we represent it in normal number line? So, we are going to see that first. So, first we will take only this open interval we will consider first. So we will consider the open interval here. Open interval. So how we are going to represent? You know that how to represent set. There are two methods of representing a set. One is tabular form, that is roster form, and another one is set builder form. This real number collection normally we cannot express in roster form. So we'll see how we are going to express this interval in set builder form. So set of all x such that, suppose if a and b are, let a comma b are two real numbers and a is less than b, then the set of all real numbers, set of all real numbers between a and b, between a and b is open interval AB, that is open interval where the endpoints a and b are not included. So is called the open interval AB. Then the open interval AB we can represent in set builder form as set of all x such that x is a real number. So x is a real number and x lies between a and b. So this is how you have to represent an open interval. Now how will you represent this in number line? So we will draw number line, plus infinity, minus infinity. Assume here the points, that is numbers a and b. Then if it is open interval, this endpoints will not be there in the collection, in the set. So here we will put a hole. This endpoints will put a hole. Like this we will mark the endpoints. Then the in between region, actually this region belongs to that collection. So in between region we have to darken. So this is how we will represent an open interval in the number line. So now we will move on to the next one. Second one, this is open interval. Now the second one, closed interval. So closed interval, how will you represent closed interval AB in set builder form? So we can see closed interval, we will use this symbol, this bracket for closed interval. So closed interval AB is equal to set of all x such that x belongs to R and the endpoints are included here. So A less than or equal to x less than or equal to B. So how will you represent this on number line? So here we'll consider the number line minus infinity to plus infinity. We have the point A, number A and B here. Since the endpoints A and B are included, we'll darken this point, we will darken these two points. And in between region also we will darken. So this is how we will represent the closed interval in number line. Now we will see closed open and open closed. How will you write the set builder form? How will you represent a set builder form? Closed open. Third one, closed open interval. So here closed open means one endpoint A is included but B is not included. So set of all x such that x belongs to R, A less than or equal to x less than B. So this is how we will represent closed open interval in set builder form. Now we will denote this number line. We will represent this on number line, minus infinity plus infinity. Here we have A and B. So if you see here, this endpoint A is included. So it should be darkened, this point. And B is not there. So there should be a break, that is a hole. And the in-between region you have to shift. So this is how we will represent closed open interval in a number line. Now the fourth one, open closed interval. Open closed interval. So here the collection. So we will see A closed open AB is equal to set of all x such that x belongs to R where the endpoint A is not included but B is included. So this is the set will the form of open closed interval. So here how we are going to represent our number line, this is plus infinity minus infinity. We have the point A and B, number A and B. A is not included, so we will use this symbol, and B is included, so we will darken this portion. Then the in between region we will darken. So this is how we have to represent open closed interval in a number line. So these are the four types of intervals. Each these intervals are all subsets of real number. Now here we have to learn one more concept, that is length of the interval. Length of the interval. What do you mean by length of the interval? Actually, the number b minus a. So it may be any type of interval. It may be open interval, closed interval, or semi-open or semi-closed. In all these four type of intervals, the number b minus a is called the length of the interval. For example, if I am writing open interval 1, 4, then the length of this interval, actually this is a and this is b. So length of this interval is 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So the number b minus a is called the length of the interval. So now we'll see the next concept. So the next concept is universal set. So what do you mean by universal set? So if there are some sets under consideration, then a set which can be taken as a superset of each one of the set, then it is called a universal set. Okay. So if there are, or we can say that in any context, the possible supersets are called universal set. So you will see some examples for this. First, let us consider the set of natural numbers. So we are going to have a discussion on set of natural numbers. For this set, what are the possible supersets we can choose? So for example, if it is natural number, then we can take whole number as a possible superset. Whole number is a superset for this. Or integers is a superset of this collection, natural numbers. Or rational numbers or real numbers. So all these supersets, these are called the universal set. Universal set. So possible superset, if we are discussing about any particular set, then a set which can be taken as a superset of the given set is called the universal set. So it is usually denoted by the letter U. So we'll see one more example. Set of isosceles triangle. So if you consider this set of isosceles triangle, can you give some superset for this? Yes, set of all triangles. If you take set of all triangles, this is the superset of this collection. Or we can say that this collection is a subset of this. So this is a universal set. This set we can take as a universal set. Or we can take set of polygons. Set of polygons also we can take as universal set. So this is the example, universal set. We'll take one more example for universal set. Suppose if I am taking set A is equal to 0, 1, 2. B is equal to 6, 8. C is equal to 4, 7, 5. So we have your three sets A, B, C. Now you have to consider, you have to find out a set which is the superset of each one of these sets. So that is called the universal set. So we can take universal set as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Can we take this set as universal set? Here if you see, this A is contained in this set. Yes, A is a subset of U. What about this set? C is also subset of U. But what about B? Here we have a 6, but 8 is not there in the set U. So here we cannot call this U as universal set. If you add 8 also, if you add 8, if you include 8, then we can call this set as the universal set of these three sets. Clear? So now we will go to example sums. Example 1, write the following intervals in set builder form. So we have already studied the different types of intervals and we have seen how to represent each interval in set builder form. Now we will see some examples for this. So here the first question is open interval -3, 0. You know that if this bracket is there, then you have to read it as open interval -3, 0. So how will you represent this as set builder form? So open interval -3, 0 is equal to set of all x such that x is the real number and it is between -3 and 0. So this is how we have to represent open interval in set builder form. Now we go to the second question. Here closed interval 6, 12. So set of all x such that x belongs to R, and you know that closed interval, enclosed interval, both the endpoints are included. So we can write 6 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 12. So this is the set builder form. Now the third one, closed open interval. So here you know that closed place, this endpoint, that is -23, is included and 5 is not included. So we will write this as set of all x such that x belongs to R and -23 less than or equal to x less than 5. So this is how you have to represent intervals in set builder form. Now we will see the second question, the reverse. Example 2, write the following as interval. So here we have the set builder form. We have to rewrite this in interval, as intervals. So first question, set of all x such that x belongs to R, -4 less than x less than or equal to 6. So here you see, this is from -4 to 6, where 6 is included and -4 is not included. So this -4 plays open interval. See, this open and here it is closed. So open, closed, -4, 6. This is how we have to represent. Now the second question, set of all x such that x belongs to R, -12 less than x less than -10. Here we have no equal sign. That means both the endpoints are not included. So it is an open interval. So we will represent this as -12, -10. Open interval -12, -10. Now the third question, set of all x such that x belongs to R, 3 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 4. Here if you see, we have equal sign. That means the endpoints are included. So this is a closed interval. So we can write closed interval 3, 4. So this is how we have to write the set builder form into intervals. Now we will see few more examples. Example 3. Given the sets A is equal to set 1, 3, 5 and B is equal to set 2, 4, 6 and C is equal to set 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Which of the following may be considered as the universal sets for all the three sets A, B and C? Here we have three sets and we have few more sets given. So you have to find out which of these sets can be the universal set for this three sets A, B, C. So we will check one by one. So first we will take the first set. Here if you see, first set we will take set A. The elements are 1, 3, 5. So whether we have 1, 3, 5? Yes, we have 1, 3, 5. So A is a subset of this set. Now we will check for B. 2, 4, 6. Whether we have 2, 4, 6 here? Yes. We have 2, 4, 6 elements are there in the given set also. So So B is also a subset of this set. Now what about C? Here 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. 0, 2, 4, 6. But 8 is not there. So we can say that C is not a subset of the given set. So this set we cannot consider as the universal set of A, B and C. So this set cannot be the universal set. Now what about null set? Null set, you know, null set cannot be the superset of any. Null set means no elements are there in the set. So this also cannot be the universal set. Now we will go to the third one. Here if you see 0, first set 1, 3, 5. Yes, 1, 3, 5 is there. So A is a subset of this set. Now B, 2, 4, 6. We will check 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6. Yes, B is also there. Elements of B is also there in this set. So B is also a subset of this set. Now 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Yes, C, all the elements of C is also there in this set. So this set can be the universal set of A, B and C. Now what about this set? If you see here 1, 3, 5 again, if you are checking, A is contained in this set. 2, 4, 6. Yes, B is also contained in this set. 2, 4, 6, 8, but C, the 0 is not there in this set. So, this is also not a universal set. So, this is how you have to identify the universal set. Thank you, students.